Hey, it's Matt and JJ.
And today we're gonna show you how to blur your videos.
Like this.
Hey.
All right, let's get started.
Let's get started.
So I'm gonna show you three ways to add blur to your videos. First, we're gonna do it in camera where the background's blurred out, but your subject's still in focus. And then I'll show you two other ways in post-production back in the studio, but we'll do that a bit later. So first off, how do I achieve background blur in my video? The main thing you wanna focus on is your aperture.
Aperture is an adjustable hole within a lens through which light travels into the camera body. It is calibrated in f-stops and is generally written as numbers such as 1.4, 2, 2.84, 5.6, 8, 11, and 16. Aperture controls your exposure and depth of field.
So I'm going to show you a couple different examples so you can see the difference in f-stop when I change my aperture. And you're going to notice when I'm shooting JJ here, the background will change a bit. You'll see when the f-stop is set at f2, you're going to notice that it's completely out of focus. And then when I go up to f5.6, you'll start to notice details in the background a little bit more. And then I'll go up to f13, you'll start to really see those individual blades of grass back there.
So keep in mind, when you want to change your aperture so you can get that nice blurry background, you want to have your camera in manual. Most DSLR cameras will have a little dial on top and you can see an M there, so you want to go ahead and set that.
All right, so I think that looks great. Now let's head in the studio and I'm going to show you two ways to add blur in post-production using Filmora.
All right, so we're back in the studio and we're gonna apply some blur effects to our footage that we just shot outside. And we're gonna use Filmora to do that. Now, you might be wondering, what's a blur effect? Simply put, it's making a part of your image or all of it out of focus. Now, why would you use a blur effect? There might be private information on the screen that you wanna cover up. You might have gaming footage and there's a comment section on the right side. You wanna cover that up as well. But the most common use is, say you have a dialogue with two people talking and you want to focus on the speaker and make the other person blurred out so that your viewer's attention is drawn into the person speaking. All right, so let's get started on applying our blur effects. So the first thing you want to do is import your media files. So you can do that by clicking on import, import media files, and I'm just going to click on the one media file I have here and hit open. So once that's loaded into your media library, you can drag and drop that down onto the timeline. And I'm just gonna make a quick edit to this one. I just wanna make it a little shorter. I'll delete that first bit. So the first blur effect I'm gonna teach you is the tilt shift. Now what the tilt shift does, it's basically a rectangle area and everything between those two lines in the rectangle is gonna be in focus and everything outside of those lines is gonna be out of focus. So you can do that by selecting your clip and then you want to go ahead and click on the power tool. So with the power tool open, you'll see that tilt shift is the first option. So you can click on this little checkbox here and that will create the tilt shift. So now I can move it around. I can move it around and I can resize it. So if I grab the edges, I can actually change the size of it. And you can see between the lines, everything's in focus and outside of it, it's out of focus. And if I want to move it around, I can do that by just clicking on the middle here. So say you have a shot like this where there's a person right in the middle of the camera and you want to draw the viewer's attention on them. So what you can do is just adjust the bars to your liking, wherever you want to put them. And that way everything outside of it is out of focus, so people's eyes will be drawn towards that person on camera, right? Another option, say you want it to be completely out of focus, you can actually shrink the tilt shift way down and then just move it to the side. So there might be a case where you need to blur out someone's face, you know, again, going back to protecting identities or whatnot, or you can do that. Also, I believe you can also spin it, just a little bonus tip. So if you ever want to go horizontal, you can, if you just go on the edge of the circle there, you can actually spin it to different angles. Now the other one that you can apply is mosaic. You probably most commonly see this when either license plates get blurred out or when someone's face is being protected or covered up. So mosaic is also in the power tool and you can click on that one to open it up. And then same thing, you just click on the check mark box here, and then you want to hit add, and it will create a mosaic box for you. So I'm just going to resize this so it's covering JJ's face. And then if you want, you also have the option to change the percentage. So if you want this to be small pixels, you go to the left. And if you want it to be bigger pixels, you go to the right. So I'm gonna leave it around, let's say 20 there. And I'm just gonna play it back for you. So you can see there, now you got a blurred out face. If you hit okay, it will be applied to your video in the timeline. And that's three ways that you can apply blur to your videos. Let us know in the comments section below where you've added blur in your videos. Thanks so much for watching, guys. If you want to check out some more great videos, we got two for you right here. Click on those. If you want to get more Filmora videos in your YouTube feed, you can subscribe by clicking here. And if you like this video, we would appreciate the support. So if you click on the like button down there, that'd be awesome. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.